Here is Paul Gemignani, greeted by the audience assembled here at Avery Fisher Hall. And the second half of our program will begin.
Into a star. It's only that. Who else but a bosom?
Renee Fleming, I Could Have Danced All Night, from the Lerner and Lowe musical, My Fair Lady. And in just a few moments, another of the great moments from the American musical stage, as we welcome the return of Dwayne Croft.
Joy, joy, joy. and bunking in, gets to feeling too soft and cozy. When the grub they've been cooking me gets to tasting too good. When I've had all I want of the ladies in the neighborhood, she sings,
Joey, Joey, from Frank Lesser's The Most Happy Fellow. Dwayne Croft. Paul Gemignani conducting the American Theater Orchestra. Next, a trio. Renee Fleming, Frederica von Stade, and Marilyn Horn.
Eagles and storks are
Renee Fleming, Frederica Finstada, and Marilyn Horne. Sing for Your Supper from the Rogers and Hart musical, The Boys from Syracuse. Next, Duane Croft, Jerry Hadley, Elizabeth Futro, and Samuel Raimi with This Is My Beloved from Wright and Forrest's Kismet.
I saw her this morning in the Bazaar of Caravans. I must find her.
Now tell me about it.
Who is he?
He's a gardener. That's all I know.
You'd say his eyes were
sometime bright,
but only sometime.
Often dark.
Well, that is plain.
Plain words can't tell the thrill.
Begin the search.
Don't worry, I'll find him for you.
Thank you.
Music of Borodin, adapted for the musical Kismet by Wright and Forrest. Elizabeth Futro, Jerry Hadley in the middle, Dwayne Croft at the left of your screen. And Samuel Raimi was also heard. This is My Beloved. And next, a return by Friederike von Stade. One of the most tender moments from the Broadway musical theater, Sleepin' Bee, from Harold Arlen's House of Flowers, sung by Friederike von Stade. Old Man River.
Let me go away from the white man born.
with pain, tope and march, lift and fail, get a little drunk, and your land's in
from Jerome Kern's Showboat. Paul Gemignani conducted the American Theater Orchestra and the men of the Concert Chorale of New York. And now our entire solo ensemble comes back to the stage for Make Our Garden Grow from Leonard Bernstein's Candide. But first, the applause and the whistles continue for Samuel Ramey. Here is our cast.
We will not think noble because we are not noble. We will not live in perfect harmony because there is no such thing in this world, nor should there be. We can only promise to do our best and to live out our lives. Dear God, that is all we can promise in truth. Marry me, Cunegonde.
You've been a fool, and so have I. But come and be my wife, and let us try before we die to make some sense of life. We're neither pure nor wise nor good. We'll do the best we know. We'll build our house and chop our wood and make our
I thought the world
questions?
From Leonard Bernstein's Candide, Gooseflesh Time, Make Our Garden Grow. Our entire ensemble of soloists this evening, joined by the tenor Mark Thompson. And as our cameras pan across the faces of our singers, there's Dwayne Croft on the left, Elizabeth Futrell, Paul Gemignani, the music director of this evening, who conducted the American Musical Theater Orchestra. Renee Fleming in the purple gown. Elizabeth Futrell, Renee Fleming, Jerry Hadley, Dwayne Croft, Marilyn Horn, Frederica Funstada, Samuel Ramey, Mark Thompson, and Paul Gemignani. And as you can see, the audience here in Avery Fisher Hall has had a fulfilling evening of American musical theater music. And our principals come back. Paul Gemignani has been the music director for many, many Broadway shows. And he has been a one-man crusade, well, not a one-man, but certainly one of those who has been in the forefront of contemporary American musical theater and reminiscing of the recent past. As I said at the outset, the stage here in Avery Fisher Hall has been decorated in a manner unusual from what the normal procedure is. There is a very large red curtain draped across the back of the stage. That you don't see here at Avery Fisher Hall often. Well, here comes Jerry Hadley.
You ain't heard nothing yet. And listen to the lullaby of Broadway.
Nanny Poray and Ballyhoo, the lullaby of Broadway. The rumble of the subway trains, the rattle of the taxis, the daffodils who entertain, and Angelos and Maxis.
It's early in the morning.
Manhattan babies don't sleep tight until the dawn.
Good night, baby. Good night. Lipman's on his way.
Sleep tight, baby. Sleep.
Thank you.
The Lullaby of Broadway, and Together. And indeed, there they were, all on the stage, all together. Our seven principal singers, joined by Beth Clayton, mezzo-soprano, Nicole Folan, soprano, and Mark Thompson, tenor. Paul Gemignani asking the players of the orchestra to rise. Men and women of the Chorale of New York. And there in the center, Elizabeth Futrell, Jerry Hadley, Renee Fleming, Paul Gemignani, Dwayne Croft, Frederica von Stade, Samuel Ramey, and Marilyn Horn. A celebration of the American Musical Theater, live this evening, live from Lincoln Center. And I'm sure the audience will not be satisfied until our principals have returned to the front of the stage. I would assume that they were all backstage, taking deep breaths, and now here they are returning, along with Paul Gemignani. Well, we had what amounts to a cavalcade of the American Musical Theater. The earliest, Victor Herbert, right up to the present time, because Leonard Bernstein's Candide has been touring the States in a revival, and it will open shortly here in New York. I'd like to remind you and invite you to join me at the Live from Lincoln Center website at PBS Online to learn more about this program and about future programs in our Live from Lincoln Center series. The next program will be on Sunday afternoon, May 4th, and it will be a celebration of the music of Johannes Brahms by the Chamber Music Society of Lincoln Center. 1997, of course, is the 100th anniversary of the death of Brahms, and his music is performed extensively throughout this season, not only in this country, but worldwide. Again, our principals have been recalled by the audience, and the applause is punctuated by cheers and some whistles. Well, about our next Live from Lincoln Center program, Sunday afternoon, May 4, as I've said, but as I always do, I caution you to check your local newspapers for the exact time and the date of broadcast in your area. Live will be on Sunday afternoon, May 4. And the Chamber Music Society of Lincoln Center has invited violinist Pinchas Zuckerman to join the artists of the society. These artists include violinist Ida Kavafian, violist Paul Neubauer, pianist David Golub, and cellist Gary Hoffman. The program will include Brahms' Quintet No. 2 for strings in G major, his Opus 111, with guest artist Cynthia Phelps, who is the solo violist of the New York Philharmonic, joining them. The program will include as well the Piano Quintet in F minor with David Golub, and soprano Jessie Norman joins Mr. Zuckerman and Mr. Golub for a performance of Brahms's two songs for contralto, viola, and piano, Opus 91. Paul Gemignani, as I said, has been a remarkable force in the American Musical Theater for the past couple of decades. He has been music director for more than 25 Broadway shows. Among them are included Into the Woods, Follies, Pacific Overtures, Sweeney Todd, Dreamgirls, Evita, and on and on. The American Theater Orchestra has been formed by Mr. Gemignani specifically for the purpose of playing these great American classics. He has also performed American music with, in addition to the American Theater Orchestra, the San Francisco, the Royal Philharmonic, and the London Symphony Orchestras. And he has appeared in several video productions, one dedicated to the music of Stephen Sondheim, and also a performance of A Little Night Music, which we had here in one of our earlier Live from Lincoln Center presentations. In 1989, Paul Gemignani received a special Drama Desk Award, and in 1994, the Los Angeles Drama Critics Award. This is Martin Bookspan. Good evening.